Movies which claim themselves as cool and stylish will probably have unwanted ear-raping BGMs at unnecessary situations that is created, which is unnecessary to the story. But cool movies don't require these cliché moments in them. Sometimes they just require a good story, characters and a twist that makes you question what you've watched. Yeah, I'm talking about the movie Fight Club by David Fincher, adapted from the novel Fight Club by Chuck Palahniuk. The smooth screenplay describing the characters via cool visuals and the dark humor behind their situations are the exciting things about this movie. And now we are going to break the rule for this video and going to talk about Fight Club. Sorry, Tyler. Movie begins with Tyler pointing the gun in mouth of the narrator. Yes, Edward Norton is called as narrator in the movie because his character don't have any name. Then narrator starts to explain about Tyler and his plan on blowing up the buildings. Now we come to narrator's own story about his insomniac life and obsession with unwanted things, joining the groups of men with different diseases like testicular cancer and others to relieve himself. But he is interrupted by Marla Singer, who pretends like him, and narrator loses his sleep again because of her. Finally, they agree to split groups, and narrator gets her number. After that, narrator's depressing work life is shown, like traveling to different states again and again for recall investigation. Then he finally meets Tyler during his flight, who makes soap and finds him interesting. When narrator finally reaches his home, he only sees his condo glowing and burnt ashes from his house. He recalls about leaving the gas turned on may cause the accident. Now he calls Marla to ask her for space, but he remembers about Tyler and calls him. They meet in the bar and starts to fight each other for fun. Tyler offers narrator some place in his rotting, water-dripping, stinky apartment. Tyler and narrator starts to visit the bar regularly and have raw fistfights between them until blood spills. This grabs attention of others in the bar, and they start to join them. Now their group becomes huge and they need to organize them. So they name their group as Fight Club, and Tyler creates rules for the club. Now narrator shows up to his workplace with wounds and blood-stained outfit, which annoys his boss. Tyler starts to have relationship with Marla, which irritates narrator and breaks his joy and thrill from the Fight Club. Narrator gets call from police regarding the investigation about his house accident, and they begin to doubt him. Tyler and narrator starts to make soap by stealing gross surgical fat from biomedical waste depot. Then Tyler leaves mark of chemical kiss on narrator's hand with unbelievable pain to mark him as club member, and spits his philosophical facts. Now the place where their and Fight Club is threatened by owner of the bar. Tyler, however, manages to scare the shit out of the owner, and he agrees to continue the club activities. Tyler starts to assign homework for club members, which they need to do with public now. Narrator seen enough in his job and decides to throw himself out by self-harming, mentioning Jack, which he calls as himself, and he finally gets fired and gets business deal from the same company he got fired. Tyler assigns club members for more assignments that they start to destroy popular brands and structures. And Tyler starts to hire members for Project Mayhem, who called as space monkeys. Now Fight Club became huge that they threaten police commissioner to not fuck with any of their activities. Robert, known as Bob, gets shot by police during one of their assignments, and from now on, Tyler starts to slowly disappear from everything he started. Narrator starts to search Tyler and tries to end whatever he and Tyler started, but wherever he went he can't find him, and slowly starts to realize that Tyler is no one but narrator himself. Yes, his extreme insomnia had came along with serious case of split personality and schizophrenia. Then he tries to surrender to the police for the things he did, but it also turns out to be part of his own plan, because Fight Club even has members in police department too. The climax part is the execution of Project Mayhem and narrator's escape from Tyler. That's the end of story. Now it's time to reality comparison. Let's go, guys. In start, narrator is shown as having serious case of insomnia because of his unsatisfied work life. The way he explains about insomnia is what it is, guys. Yes, these are the symptoms of insomnia. In reality, if we saw someone talking to and punching themselves like maniac, we will definitely consider them as crackhead and advise them to have medical consultation, but in the movie they joins him. It's funny how people follow a man who beats himself and joins him later to create Fight Club. There's no proper explanation on how narrator single-handedly forms club by beating himself. Making of soap shown in the movie with ingredients and chemicals wanted them to create is accurate. Now they speak about nitroglycerin in soaps and their explosive nature and process to make them. This is how soaps and dynamite from nitroglycerin is made. Nitroglycerin is added little bit when making soaps, so that no one doubts they are making explosives. These parts of movie executed logically. Then Tyler pours some sodium hydroxide on narrator's hand to mark him as club member. Then pours vinegar on his hand to neutralize it. This is the exact way to neutralize the lye burn on skin, and it's perfectly done. Again, how Tyler gets all these money to organize a group and make explosives? This is why Tyler sells soap, and narrator gets deal from his company where he worked, so they'll have enough funds to run the group. And the people Tyler gathers are associated with various work types, who can then use their jobs to exploit and do stuff Tyler says is logical, and there's nothing wrong in this. The interactions with Marla and narrator is made the way that Tyler and narrator never meet each other when Marla is in the house. So she never doubts narrator for talking with himself, and only thinks he is weird. So she never gets a clue about narrator's split personality condition. Project Mayhem in movie is well set and well planned, and they have no issues in achieving the result. Because as we said before, they have people working in various departments, and there's no strong security measures from police, because they threaten the police commissioner. The idea of blowing up credit card company buildings is to erase everyone's bank record, so everyone goes economically zero. But this is not how economy works. If these kind of situations occur, there'll be lots of safety measures in government, and they can recover in some time. However, the effect will be deadly in the period where use of computers was still growing. The final gunshot in the narrator's mouth to kill his split personality Tyler could have possibly killed him too, but however he manages to survive, and the lack of blood is not so accurate with reality. It could have killed him but survives based on luck. Fight Club is not just a movie with cool characters and story, but the relation with narrator and us are very high at some points of the movie, and the philosophy from Tyler makes us rethink our pathetic lives and makes us to question that anything is real in this society and their morals. That's the end of video, guys. I hope you remember the rule.
You met me at a very strange time in my life.